Hello everyone, and welcome to episode 2 of my favorite chess game series. Today we're looking at another Morphy game. Last time we looked at the Opera House game. This time it's Schulten versus Morphy, 1857. Morphy is playing black, and Schulten opens with e4. We have e5, f4. Okay. Morphy was quite well known for playing a lot of gambits and a lot of really attacking chess. So if you try to play a gambit against him, he's just going to hit you with a counter gambit, which is exactly what he does. He plays d5. And I believe this is called the Falkbeer counter gambit. I don't know if it's good or not. I don't know anything about the King's gambit. Anyway, white plays e takes d5. And we have e4, which makes it pretty hard to develop the kingside knight. We have knight c3, knight f6, and d3, which is hoping for us to take and help white develop. Fortunately, Morphy isn't that kind, so he plays bishop b4. We have bishop d2. And now Morphy's ready to castle, whereas his opponent is nowhere near castling. He wants to bring his rook to the e-file and attack. But the e-file is blocked by this pawn. So how can we get it out of the way? Well, we could take on d3, but that just helps him develop. So Morphy finds a solution. He plays e3. Bishop takes e3 is forced, and now he just castles. And the e-file is open, and he's ready to start attacking. So bishop back to d2. And, okay, Morphy plays a move which baffles me a little bit. He took on c3. So I suppose that removes the defender of the d5 pawn. I think more importantly, it removes the defender of the e2 square, so that when Morphy's rook comes to e8 and you block, there won't be that much defense on e2. I don't really know. If you think of a better reason why you might have played this, you can say so in the comments. Anyway, we have b takes c3, opening up to the b file, and rook e8 check. Bishop e2. And of course, bishop g4, piling up in this pinned piece. Now white plays c4, hanging on to this pawn. And yeah, that's way too greedy, in my opinion. You're going to get punished if you do that. So when you're trying to attack, you've got this lead in development. They haven't castled yet. You need to open the central files. And Morphy finds a good way to do this, which is c6. I think this is actually the most instructive moment of the whole game, except for maybe e3. White takes on c6. Now we have knight takes. So it opened up the d-file for the queen, opens up the d4 square for the knight. Okay, it also opens up the c-file, but that's not really relevant. We're trying to attack the king. So after knight takes c6, white's a little bit scared of this pin with the rook, so he plays king f1. That also seems a bit weak. Anyway, there's obviously tactics here. I'll give you a few seconds to find what Morphy played. Okay, so there's a lot of winning moves. Probably whatever you suggested is good. Morphy chose rook takes e2. We have knight takes e2 and knight d4 with this pin. So that just wins on the spot. Anyway, white plays queen b1. We have bishop takes e2. And then white played king f2. We have knight g4 check, king g1. And now we need a way to get this knight out of the way so that we can get our queen into the attack. Morphy finds one, which is knight f3 check, g takes f3, and queen d4 check. We have king g2, queen f2 check, king h3, queen takes f3. I think you get the picture. King h4, and our nice quiet move that threatens mate, knight h6. We have queen g1, now knight f5 check, king g5, and queen h5 mate. So that's a nice little miniature, just like the Opera House game. And this one really shows that when you've castled and your opponent hasn't, or even when you've just got a lead in development, you have to open the center. Like with that e3 move, that c6 move, they were both aimed at opening the central files. So I think that's really the lesson to take away from this. Anyway, I'll be back again next time, probably with another Morphy game. Maybe not. Let's see.